how's it going? How's it going? How's it going? Hi, 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 hi. Hello there. Hello there. Hey. I'm gonna load in, then I gotta go to the bathroom. I'll be right back. You're just too good. That's right. You're too on the ball. I don't know if I deserve that sort of viewership. I don't know if I deserve it. They love me. They really love me. All right, where am I doing? Oh, yeah. Let's go. Fly! Fly! No, I need to fly to the bathroom. I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back. Hey. No, 747, sorry. Not today, I'll do it tomorrow maybe. I already had this plan. Yes, sir. I've been really wanting to, Yeah, no 747. I haven't flown this in such a long time. Okay. Oh yeah, I gotta do my V-pilot thing. Okay. IFR KMSO 2 KRNT 2050. Okay, and get rid of this. Okay, route. Okay, RWY. Oops. 30. Diddly 5 departure. That's amazing. I suggest. What do you suggest? I'm Go Flight Radar for suggestions. The first short flight over my house, I suggest.
What are you suggesting? D I D L Y 5 departure. It was actually a 747. That's amazing. To J70. Oh, Airway J70. And Korean Air, that's cool. Oh, transition. Actually, two, yeah. S K Y K O 1 arrival. Transition. Transition. Echo Papa Hotel. Let's see. Let's see. R N A V Zulu. And approach. 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 I gotta go. ACH. Those are cool looking. Oh yeah. Approach runway. Did I say Z? Yeah, okay. Zulu approach runway. 1-6. Transition. Let's see. Waypoints as follows. DIDLY. Oh yeah, caps like that. DIDLY. That's so funny. Diddly. Diddly is a departure name. ORONE. Mike Lima Papa. O D D E S S. Echo Papa Hotel. Skyco S K Y K O. Huvus H U V U S. H E T H R. Let's see. L U T S Y. W I B A T. And that's that. Minimum 668. Oh, right? Yeah. Okay, that's fine. Save, close, connect, enhance, vision jet. Enhance. Flight plan filed. Enhance. Controllers. Ooh, I'm not close to him. And I'm not close to him either. Sag news. Sag. Let's see. Let me see.
Ooh, that's a cool one.
Yeah, he's all the way over there. Let me see where I'm at. I'm in Salt Lake City, technically, but I probably wouldn't get Salt Lake City Center to give me love if I was here. So, I think I'd be too far away. That's okay. We'll rock and roll on Unicom. Enhance.
What's that? A380 London to Singapore, A380 Singapore Airlines. That's cool.
Okay. Pre-flight test.
What are you question marking? I don't understand.
Not today. Maybe another day, for sure. I'll probably do that. London to Singapore, yeah. I don't have an A380. I've got to get an A380. I could probably find one that's decent, I guess.
For sure. Yeah, man, I do that. I've been meaning to do a intercontinental sort of thing. Not intercontinental, international. I could do 747 sometime. I was going to do A319. I forget what I was going to do. I was going to do, I think, Seattle to Tokyo, maybe. Or Seattle to London. Or something like that. I wanted to fly in international. Fly in into London City in my A319. Yes, sir. A319 CEO. It's got big old center tanks. Big old center tanks. Nah, just the CEO and the private jet. Looks right. Yeah. What? No charts. What? Oh, whatever. Who cares?
Oh yeah, I gotta do the settings. Let's go track. Yeah. Wait, what was it? Heading up. And the wind settings. No, wait. Do I? Oh, it's not on. That's right. Okay. Okay. And one. Yeah, so 2 2 8 0 0 transfer. Tracks on B pilot, that's good. Yeah, that it's a special though, good one. Oops, yeah. The A319 with the extra huge. Something amazing. Oh yeah, and then what was what? And what was that? Check my chart. Oh, you know what? Actually, I'll do this before I get going. Load. Enhance. Is that right? That's right. Okay, so this one. $747 probably. So that's like, so we'll go 8,000. Yeah. 747. Turn the ice lights on too, because those are dope. Let's check out what we got going on here. So I'm gonna come over here, I think. Look at that. This is a cool airport. So we go over this way, go over here. Look at that. Oh man, this is dope. Shout out to Missoula. Oh, that's silly. All right, where am I at? What am I doing? What's the plan? Okay, here we go. All right, let's start up this old here engine. 2, 3. Bon voyage me. Let me see. How to say bye to a girl. Bye. Bon voyage me, old cream cracker. That's silliness. That's peak silliness. Alright, where are we at?
good green. Flaps. Set. Check. Landing lights. I'm on right now. All right. Let's rock and roll. It's another day in London. Let me see before I get going. I like that one. That's a good one. Is it you just sitting there on the subway, on your train, London train, in full battle gear, full suit of armor? All right, Missoula traffic, Vision Jet 125 Foxtrot. Taxiing to runway 30 on the Diddley 5 departure, climbing to 8,000. I see the word Diddley. It's real, and I'm going like, oh my gosh. All right, one more, then I gotta get going. Okay. Please do not pose in this pose. There's a bird hatching eggs inside. We're temporarily. That's funny. It's all coffee. That's funny. There's a bird hatching eggs inside. That's so cool though. It's kind of sweet. Make sure I get the trim right for landing this time. I always come in too flat. On the Vision Jet, I was coming in too flat. I think that's my trim. Got wind today, huh? Look at that. Look at the old Sackerson. Over. Okay. It's pretty, all those crazy names for coffee. That's true. They are interesting names. Ow. Yep. Oh my gosh. How am I not getting any wind data? If there's wind. What I want to know is, that's what I want to know. think the X-Plane Vision Jet didn't have auto throttle, did it? X-Plane 11
Vision Jet?
I don't think it did.
Missoula traffic, Vision Jet 125 Foxtrot, departing runway 30. Climbing to 8,000 on the Dudley 5 departure. Let's make sure we're not gonna... He's over there. He's over there. And I'm in here. Okay, we got flaps. Lights are on. We got air. Ace not needed. Everything looks good. Okay, let's go. Oh my gosh, what is with the wind? What is that? It's not saying I have any wind. Some vertical speed. We got nav. Flaps up. Bring it down some. We get some more speed. Oh yeah, we do have some wind, do we? That's okay. We can deal with that.
Oh no. That it's traffic. I'm getting a TCAS? Did you see him? And he disappeared. What? Oops, I'm over speed now. Holy smokes. He didn't even land, he just disappeared. I didn't even see him. He like just appeared right in front of us. Flew underneath us, straight up like, yeah, exactly. Like Sean Connery, no, Pierce Brosnan style James Bond. Disappeared again. Didn't even land. Amazing. That was amazing.
traffic. Division Jet 125 Foxtrot at 8,000 for flight level 300. Oh, but I went all the way up. Oh no, never mind. Actually, correction, flight level 180.
That's fine.
It's only gonna go to 14, but I'll be passing. Passing through. Here.
Looking good. Saying that the Vision Jet's underpowered. Do you think the Vision Jet's underpowered? Thank you. I'll see you soon. Thank you. like that. I appreciate it.
How you doing? Good to see you. Doing great. How are you doing? Doing good? Doing good. So good to see you. Very good to see you. Nice. Yes, you deserve it. Nice. Yeah. Almost there, huh? A little Tarkov. Been a little bit since I played. Been a little bit since I played Tarkov. Well, like what, a month or something. It's been like a month since I played Tarkov. Yeah. I like Tarkov. Turn up for you. How's that? Is that a little bit better? Alright, here we go. There we go. Yeah, I put a little Tarkov here and there. We'll see quite soon, though. A lot of fun. It can be brutal at some point. Tarkov is pretty brutal. Dude, friendly guy was having a hard day yesterday at a certain point there. Like, it shows you how, like, yeah. Too casual to get. Yeah, it's like, very brutal. Yeah. There was like a couple, or a few raids where he loaded in and, like, he was dead immediately. Like, I think one of them was a hacker, right? Remember that? He, like, loaded right in with the squad. Taking all that time to load in with a squad and, like, died immediately. And then another one, he, like, loaded in a minute later. He, like, it was in, like, I think so. That was Lighthouse. I went to go grab some, heat up some cold pizza. And I heard, like, him getting shot in the head, like, the, you know, the ping. I was like, wait, what? Didn't he just load in? Oh, yeah. It's in a weird state. It's pretty interesting. Because, like, it feels like there's so much focus on the white, right? Like, ugh! It seems like most, like, of the hardcore Tarkov players, they're, like, happy for, like, the first month of the wipe, but they play so much, and they like, you know, get so into it that it's just, like, after that month, they start, like, going, oh, where's the wipe, and I'm like, wait, what, didn't the wipe just happen? It seemed like, I always thought it was, like, man, everything's about the wipe. The white. I was like, man, can you imagine if it wasn't a white? And that's what I was thinking, like, oh, yeah. It's, yeah. Interesting game. I like it a lot. I was playing quite a bit for a little while. I don't know, where did I get up to, like, level 30 or something? Nothing that crazy. But yeah, you can get eaten alive, man. And I remember before VoIP, it was a different time. It was different. There was a time when VoIP first came out too. It was like everyone was, like, happy, like everyone was talking to each other, so they didn't want to kill each other. Man, don't shoot me, I'm trying to quest. Oh, okay. Yeah, right? But then it was like, it sent in that, like, we've got to kill people anyways. We've got to, you know what I mean? We've got to quest anyways. So it's like, so it then became like the Tarkov betrayals. The betrayals. I'm friendly and they shoot you, man. Oh, man. Yeah. Right. Right. He used
to go up to dudes and just like drop the, you know what I mean? They'd be like, what? That's right. That was crazy. Yeah, he would, he'd drop like a red card on, you know what I mean? Red Rebel for people, you know, that if they were friendly, he would just, yeah. Dude, I remember that. And he would see other streamers too. And be like, wait, that's the guy. That's the guy who gives people stuff. Yeah. It seems like the developers, they're always looking to get like sharing keys and key cards and stuff like that. Like they're trying to get rid of all these loopholes. It feels like, and like a lot of it, and like it seemed like they nerfed getting good loot from marked rooms and stuff like that, and like the good rooms and labs, to where it doesn't really matter. Like you never get anything good in marked room. I was like, what's the point? My little son Michael loves Tarkov, but hey, everyone's like, oh yeah, sure, a 4-year-old could play Tarkov, no big deal. 4-year-old play Tarkov, that's no big deal. Yeah, but and here's the problem we ran into. He'd go to school, you know, a 4-year-old, and he would want to act out one of his favorite games, right? So he would, you know, be shooting his friends and going through their pockets on the schoolyard. And he's looting his, you know what I mean, looting them. It's like, oh, no, you can't do that. Not today's thing. You know what I mean? Picking up a stick and pretending to shoot him, you know, and then loot him. Like, nah, I can't do that in today's class. It's pretty funny. It's I mean, it's cute. But not in today's climate. Like, yeah, you can't knock over the other kids and go through their pockets. He wasn't nothing like that. He was a nice boy. He was just, you know, he'd be like a little stick, you know. Like, well, I used to do that when I was a kid, you know what I mean? But you can't really talk about looting bodies at school anymore, I guess. Not like you could ever, I don't know. This is funny. Like, yeah. What are you gonna do? Yeah. Yeah. Right? It was no big deal. Yeah. It's different now. Different now. Pellet gun shooting squirrels. Yeah, man. That was, you know, kids being kids. Normal kid stuff. It feels like they're like, kids are like, I don't know, the internet or whatever, but they're like, feels like we're kind of robbing our kids of like child, you know, of being the coolness of being a kid, like trying to talk to kids about politics and sexual politics. Like, kids need to be outside playing with sticks, man. You know what I mean? Talking about what, pro wrestling and sports or whatever. Craziness. It's like, just keep that stuff away, man.
man. Kids deserve to be kids. Let them, you know what I mean? Let them do kid stuff. Don't go crazy with everything. Let them, you know what I mean? They'll get all that later.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, everything's been politicized. And that's, it's, you know, like, that was, like, the one thing. Like, the medical field was one thing where you can be like, okay, there's no politics in the medical field. It's, you know what I mean? You just have to cure diseases and you go, you know what I mean? But that, with COVID, that's like, no way. Now it's like, politics are in medical decisions. It's just like, whoa, that's crazy. But, you know what I mean? I'm a moderate, and that's like a radical nowadays. Being a moderate is like a radical thing now. It's like, oh, you're a moderate? What? What? Yeah, and like I don't like politics. I don't like any of that stuff. It's everything's so negative. It's so negative. You turn on the media, it's all negative stuff. To like guys like so people, you know, they're craving positive attitudes and, you know, positivity in general. But like guys like Friendly Guy, you know, I try to do it as best I can, you know what I mean? Where it's like people are craving positivity. And I think that's like lost on things because it's like there's so much negativity. Turn on the news and it's all negative stories talking about whatever, you know what I mean? That's how it is. Sad, but that's how it is. So I try to be as positive as I can. You know what I mean? Controllers on right now in my area. Portland Approach, Denver Center, Vancouver Center. How close am I? Oh, I ain't got some time. 26 nautical miles. And then we're gonna come down to flight level 20 down to 120. Over Eastern Washington. Over Eastern Washington, I believe. Yeah. Freda. Moses Lake. Odessa. Oregon Airport. Wilson Creek. Kind of cloudy. It's gonna be cloudy over there. Okay, no broken ceiling there. Can't see the mountains or anything today. Not on the horizon. Looks like it's pretty thick clouds. Overcast. song though. Cascades. You should be seeing Mount Rainier, but it's too overcast. Actually, poke its head out over here, but not today. That's okay. Eastern Washington. Very different from Western Washington. Eastern Washington, they have a lot of heat. It doesn't rain like it does in Western Washington. East of the mountains, it gets very sunny, but it also snows a lot. But Western Washington, it rains a lot. Sandwiched between the Olympics and the Cascades on the other side. A lot of rain. It does rain a lot, but not as much as it's like a popularized Seattle. Get that work done. Good time. We're going to start our descent now for our arrival. And just underneath the net service ceiling for Vision Jet, flight level 300, 30,000 feet. I think it's 31,000 feet, right? Max surface ceiling. People are saying it's higher. I think it's 310. Lots of fuel. So 80 knots. Oh, thank you. I really appreciate you. Thank you so much. Man, I appreciate you. Thank you. Yeah. I served from 2004, right after high school. I went in like a week out of high school after I graduated. I went in like a week or two after that, 2004 to 2008. Nice. Awesome. That's cool. You got lots of family members serving. Nice. Where are they? What branches are they in? Pescatore,
Lots.
Uncle's retired.
Yeah.
Oh man, that's awesome. Army Ranger cousin. Lots of that. Wow.
Wow, lots of tradition. Very cool. That's awesome.
Both your grandfathers are vets of World War II.
That's awesome. That's cool, man. The stories. Lots of good stories in your family, probably. Awesome military stories.
Thank you.
Yeah. Tough though. I mean, your whole life would be different. You know what I mean? You wouldn't be as successful as you are now, maybe. You know what I mean? Depending if you stayed in or not or whatever. I mean, a lot of sacrifices. Yeah, I mean, I think I definitely would have regretted not going in had I not done it. I think it would have been something that would have probably eaten away at me. I really, really felt strongly about going in, but I signed up in 2003, and that was like right after 9/11. I was like 15 when 9/11 happened, and in my senior year, we invaded Iraq. I know, I had already signed up, you know, for like a delayed entry. You know, I mean, in serving 4 years, you know, especially like at that time, it was tough getting there and readjusting. So strongly about it, and I felt like, you know, I was gonna back up my beliefs, you know what I mean? I was gonna back them up. It's like a it is what it is. I think that you shouldn't regret not going in. You know what I mean? A lot of your family members serve, you know what I mean? You don't gotta worry about that. You know what I mean? You're successful and you're working hard. You know what I mean? You got a lot of things to plan for. You know what I mean? You don't gotta worry about that. Your family seems to have done more than enough service. So I wouldn't worry about that. Are you from Seattle? I was thinking, yeah, you're from Seattle, right?
I don't think we had that conversation.
Yeah.
For the Seattle area?
Oh, no? Is that... Yeah, I don't think so. For some reason, because... the Seahawks. I was thinking Seahawks with your name. Huh. Yeah, where are you from? Way up. That's fine.
Oh, that's mean.
I even cringe my hair myself. No. Nothing wrong with the accent. The southern drawl. Nice. Sounds good. Close, getting pretty close. I have to make sure the gear goes down. Because I need to visually check. Sometimes I've been having problems with the vision jet, where I put the gear down, but it actually doesn't go down. Panama City Beach, Florida. Yeah. I've heard of it. Panama City Beach, Florida. Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's cool. You guys get them hurricanes? Oh, yeah. Some serious hurricanes go through that area, don't they? man, yeah. Hurricane Michael. It's crazy how bad that is. Yeah, I remember Katrina was crazy. Gulf Coast, man. Always getting hit up by... Oh. Are you back? That's scary. That's some scary stuff, man. Jeez. My lights on. Nothing happened though, right? Were you fine? Your house okay? Did it hit you? Damn. Tornado Alley. Dude, that's crazy, man. So many natural disasters. And floods, too. Doesn't always flood there, too? Oh, good. That's good. Perfect. Perfect. 12-8 right through Skyco. Perfect. Yeah, I do. So I'm on like VatSim. So like I got, there's controllers that are on. There's none on my route. But yeah, I mean, all these people, these are all people flying. Like that guy's in an F-16. He's up there in the Dark Star, 40,000 feet. He's in a Cessna 172. He's in an A310. He's in an F-18. Oh, yeah. But most of these, I think most of these people aren't on VatSim. They're just playing the game, and I like just to have it on. Yeah. So like, there's like, these guys, ATC guys, they're like really good. They're really good at what they do on VatSim. You have to take tests and stuff. And when you're dealing with them, you have to deal with it. Yeah, you gotta deal like realism. You know what I mean? So like actual call outs and communication, ATC communication. Like that you would use in real life. It's supposed to kind of like mimic real life as much as possible. To where like, yeah. So like, since I don't have any controllers on in my area, say if I had like Seattle Center on, I would be talking to him right now. Or Seattle Approach. I'd be talking to them. But since they're not on, I would, I'm just talking on Unicom. So basically, I'm just giving the other pilots around me, like, my intentions, like, what I'm doing. Yeah. Yellow traffic, Vision Jet 125 Foxtrot, passing through waypoint Kuvas at 9,000 on the Arnav Zulu approach for runway 16 for Renton. So basically, I just told all of the pilots on VatSim in my area, like what I'm doing, where I'm at. What altitude I'm at and what my intentions are. So right now I'm on the RNAV approach for Renton. Renton Airport. Municipal Airport. What I'll be doing is I'll be flying. I got like these charts. It's an IFR flight plan. So I will be flying this, and over here, let's see, here, and then I'll be landing here. I got my minimums over here. It's like, yeah, he flies a lot. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he flies a lot. He loves to fly. He's really good. Yeah, he's really good. It's impressive. He can land. He really likes doing the bush landing. Bush landings, like, you know, like small planes landing at, like, remote or remote, unimproved airports. You know what I mean? Like gravel airports or grass, stuff like that. There's some on my YouTube of him doing landing training on the on here. He's he does like he got like a perfect score. It's hard. It's hard stuff. And he's just a little guy. He loves aviation. He loves it. So I'm pretty sure he's going to be a pilot. He's in, he's on a trip right now, in California with, the rest of the family, and he calls me, and he goes, "Dad, I saw a Honda Jet, speed and down, and I'm gonna slow down. Yeah, man, for sure. I love it, man. I love playing. My older son, he liked cars a lot, so he wanted me always to play like Need for Speed on the PlayStation. So we always played Need for Speed. Yeah, we have a lot of fun. PlayStation 3. That's right. Dude, he loved the Bugatti and the Pagani. And we were doing all that. We'd play for a whole day. We'd play all day. It was a really fun game, like running from the cops, and then you get to be the cop. I like that game. Nice. For sure, for sure. Thanks for coming by, man. I appreciate you. I enjoy your company. Sounds good. Sounds good. Very cool. Washington. We got the two floating bridges. We got Bellevue down here.
Seattle. And there's where I'm landing right there. Some reason I think I turned down the graphics. I think I did. I need to turn the graphics back up. That's okay. Hopefully I won't get lagged. Seattle traffic. Vision Jet 125 Foxtrot at 3,500 for 2,100 on the RNAV Zulu approach for runway 16 at Renton. Approach for runway 16 for Renton. Taking a good look out. Taking a good look out here. The leg. I thought I made it better. Okay. I think we just need to go over a little bit. Okay.
last one. Oop, no, no. Last one, I promise. Oh, come on, man. That was sick, though. Inflict steam, man. Whoa! You're ripping! Dude, he's a good pilot. Is he landing at Boeing Field? Nope, he's climbing. Oops. Someone's in the lake over there. You got minus altitude. I should be starting a turn here. Loop-de-loo. Navigate this very crowded airspace. Once I make this turn here, put the gear down. What's he doing? Slow speed here. A slow flight.
Traffic, FedEx 1452, gonna be as far away 34 right here, departure Seattle.
Seattle.
final turn. And once we get on, let's take this turn here. Look for the turn. Seattle traffic, Vision Jet 125 Foxtrot, on final to land at runway 16 at Renton. On final to land at runway 16 at Renton. We got 3 green, flaps, airspeed good, thrust, and brakes good. Look at the weather, let's see what our wind is. Seven or eight. And 160, so perfect. Perfect, 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 perfect. We should be getting some glide slope love now. We got approach set for glide slope, for a glide path. We'll leave on the throttle on for now. We got our lights. Green flaps full, parking brakes off. We're looking good, everything looks good. Let's continue. Minimums are set. Hop over Mercer Island here in a second. Dad's house. Hi, Dad.
got some more wind coming now. What happened with the wind? Wind just smacked me in the face. Okay, so we got 15 knots. Green, flaps full, lights on, speed is good, rate is good, we are looking good. Alright, let's do this thing. Okay, the wind changed dramatically on this. This is very strange.
Renton traffic, Vision Jet 125 Foxtrot, clear of runway 16. Clear the runway at Renton. Hello, Ryanair.
so cool. I'm so glad he came to the stream. I'm glad anybody comes to the stream. Gives me good conversation. Talks. So, you know what I mean? All you guys, I really appreciate you guys. I don't say it enough, I think. Maybe I say it too much. I don't care. I appreciate you guys. I appreciate you, Shithawks. I appreciate you, Mr. Transpo. You too, Meg. I appreciate you guys. I really do. You're awesome. Hands in there. Oh, Lear fan! Yeah. Look at me. We got all sorts of cool dudes over here. Pipstrol. Yes, I know. I must go that way. looks good.
Oh, it's a diamond. See anything? Let's go check it out. Field. Oh, yeah. Hercules. Wait.
Spokane, or he came from Spokane, from the old Spokane. That. What are you guys doing in there, huh? I'll come in. There we go. There we go. Whoa. What is Joe Biden? Joe Biden pulling a Harrison Ford. Oh, nope, that's definitely not a Harrison Ford. I thought he was going to land on the taxiway. He crash landed right in front of the cargo. Rest in peace. Gonna go down a level here. Alright, now we're in it. Now we're in it to win it. Got rookie captain in the Honda Jet.
Hear anybody on the ground. I don't think there's anybody here on that side. Seattle ground, Vision Jet 125 Foxtrot, radio check.
November 125 Foxtrot, Seattle ground 5x5.
Awesome, thank you. Okay, now I can put ATC in the title. Let's go, rookie captain. Make it happen. I'm gonna go see him. Hopefully it's not generic. Oh, it's going to be a Honda Jet. Yes. Butter. Butter. Yes. Yes. Yes, the butter. You're looking mighty fine.
Delta Ground, Delta 2160, ready for taxi with Kilo.
Delta 2160, thanks for Kilo. Runway 34 right, taxi via Bravo.
Via Bravo, Delta.
Texting via Bravo. That's this long one. Right there. This long one. Bravo goes basically all the way up and down this piece right here. Start.
Delta 2160, no further ATC available, frequency change approved. Caution, there's an inbound 737 on about an 8 mile final.
Copy that, I got eyes on the traffic, no over unit, Delta
2160. Intentional aircraft tail ground now closed, monitor Unicom 12.8.
Thank you.
plane sticking out of it? Why is the plane sticking out of it? Plane-shaped Earth. What do you know about that? We got flat Earth. Got round Earth. We got hot dog glizzy-shaped Earth. Now we got plane-shaped Earth. Usually raid friendly guy, but he's not on. Who else do I raid? Nah, I don't need a raid today. We're all good. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Evening, night, whatever. I'm out of here. I'll be on tomorrow. Same time. I'll probably be on earlier, hopefully. Hopefully much earlier. But, let's see. Anyways, have a good rest of your day. Have a good rest of your day. I appreciate you guys.